Hello guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. A very good morning to all of you. I hope that you are doing good in your lives and are healthy at this moment. So let's begin the current affairs for today. But if you are a newcomer here, then do not forget to subscribe to our channel and hit this bell notification. Also guys, you can join this Telegram group where we provide you with free quizzes as well as we try to resolve your queries. Now, we have launched this 2022 course for RBI Grade B that includes PDFs, videos and mock tests. Apart from all these features, you will also get mock interviews preparation as well. In addition to this, you will get a book kit, and that book kit will have all these books which are right in front of you in this photo. So these books will be provided to you, and right now we are running a 30% discount on this course. So if you are willing to enroll yourself in some worthy course, then you can get yourself enrolled in this course by using the RBI30 coupon code. And in case you have any queries, you can just give us a call at this number. Okay, so let's begin current affairs with this first question. As per the International Energy Agency's Renewable Energy Market Update Outlook for 2021 and 2022 report, the renewable energy capacity addition increased by 45% in 2022, which is the highest year-on-year increase since 1999. So what this question is basically saying is that you have to tell the total renewable energy capacity addition that took place in the year 2020 in absolute terms, because percentage is right in front of you in the question itself, that is 45%. And this percentage is the comparison from 2019 additions. But what is the exact amount? What is the exact capacity addition that took place in 2020? So the right answer here is option C, that is 280 gigawatts. Which is an increment of 45% from 190 gigawatts. So this 190 gigawatts was the energy capacity additions in 2019. And in comparison to this, in 2020, the energy capacity additions were 280 gigawatts. And this is a very tremendous achievement for the globe, because in the year 2020, the entire globe was struggling with the pandemic of coronavirus. And despite that, this achievement is really fabulous for the entire world. Now, you would be amazed to know this thing, that from this 280 gigawatt energy capacity additions, China alone accounts for more than 50% of this addition. So just remember, it's the China that is leading the world in renewable energy capacity additions. Okay. Now let us have a look at the facts that this report has mentioned. So we have discussed these facts already. So I'm skipping these facts. Now let's discuss this fact. This 280 gigawatt comprises of solar energy, wind energy, hydro energy and other renewable energy sources. And what were their renewable energy capacity additions in 2020? So these are the amounts, these are the total energy capacity additions which are mentioned in the brackets. Now you would be thinking that, are we supposed to learn all these? The guys, my answer here is that there is no harm if you can memorize these, but the most important amount or the capacity addition is 280 gigawatts. So if you can remember this much, then it is more than sufficient for your examination. But also do not ignore the solar power. Why is this? The answer here is in this one. The reason is solar PV additions are expected to reach a record-breaking level of 162 gigawatts in 2022. So solar power is very much focused in India as well as in the entire world. So if you can remember that it is the 135 gigawatt solar power energy capacity additions that took place in 2020, then it would be very good for you in your examinations only. And just remember that you cannot skip this point, okay, because this is only the solar power that is going to reach that record breaking level. Okay, so let us have a look at the 2021 forecast provided by the International Energy Agency in this report. So in 2021, the world is expected to see additions of 270 gigawatts, and in 2022, 280 gigawatts would be added in the total renewable energy capacity. Apart from this, China again is going to lead the world in 2021 in the renewable energy additions with 45% contribution. And in 2022, it will have almost 58% contribution in the total additions of renewable energy capacity. So this is very huge, and China is again taking the lead. So China is a very important country when you talk about the renewable energy project or energy additions. So that was all about the globe, the entire world. But does this report has mentioned any fact related to India? So the answer is yes. Related to India, the facts are right in front of you. The first fact is that the renewable energy capacity additions declined by over 50% in India in 2022. And this is entirely attributable to COVID-19 pandemic. So the total additions were 5.62 gigawatts. Apart from this, majority of this addition was in the hydropower sector. Now this point is very important, the next point, that is in 2021, India will add 17 gigawatt of renewable energy capacity. And at present, India has 94 gigawatt of renewable energy capacity. That also includes hydro and biomass energy capacity. Apart from this, 34 gigawatt energy is under construction and 30 gigawatt is under bidding stages. So this 94 gigawatt is at present our capacity, and 34 gigawatts and 30 gigawatts are in addition to this 94 gigawatt capacity. So here, this report ends. I hope that you have understood it well. And in case if you have any queries later on, then you can ask me in the comment section, or you can just give me a message on the Telegram also. Achha, so we have discussed everything related to this report, but now I would like to ask a question from you. And that question is the headquarter of International Energy Agency. Where is this agency located? You have to tell me in the comment section below. Okay, so let's discuss our second question for the day. Which state has launched Mission Oxygen to encourage the private sector to generate liquid medical oxygen? So we have West Bengal, Karnataka, Kerala, Maharashtra and Delhi. In the options, out of these, the right answer is option D, Maharashtra. Now, under this Mission Oxygen, it is very clear that private sector will be encouraged. And how is the government going to encourage the private sector? By giving them incentives. So through this mission, through this scheme, the state government of Maharashtra is going to give incentives to the private sector so that they can develop the oxygen plants in the state. And as we all know, Maharashtra is the one state that is facing this coronavirus, the second wave of this coronavirus pandemic, very harshly. So remember, it's Mission Oxygen that has been launched by Maharashtra government. Now guys, apart from this Mission Oxygen, recently Indian Armed Forces also launched the COJEET mission. And the purpose of this COJEET mission is also to strengthen the supply chains for the supply of oxygen, ventilators, etc. All the equipment that are required to fight the COVID-19 pandemic. Apart from this, under this COJEET mission, Indian Armed Forces are also trying to keep the mental well-being of the people intact, and they are also working towards ensuring the supply chain of the equipments related to COVID-19 intact. So these are some of the missions that have been launched recently to combat this second wave of coronavirus. Moving on to the third question, which of the following company has launched the Farmizo Khata, a B2C farm accounting mobile application in partnership with Yono app? So this Farmizo Khata has been launched by which company? We have AgroWave, Bharat Agri, Big Heart, Shivrai Technologies, Clover Ventures. Out of these five options, the right answer is Shivrai Technologies, which is an Indian agricultural tech startup. So this agri-tech startup has launched this Farmizo Khata, and through this Farmizo Khata, through this mobile applications, farmers will be able to maintain their merchant accounts, to maintain their daily transactions online through this application. Now remember that this application has been launched in partnership with SBI's Yono application, and that makes it more important. This question becomes more important precisely because of the involvement of Yono application. Now my question from you is that where is this Shivrai Technologies located? In India. So that is your task to find out and tell me in the comment section. Okay guys, so this is our next question. Who has been appointed as the CEO of National Asset Reconstruction Company Limited? Now we have five options: Arvind Kumar, Padma Kumar, M. Nair, R. K. Dhawan, Sanjay Pandey, S. Prasanna. Out of these five options, option B, that is Padma Kumar M. Nair, is the CEO of this National Asset Reconstruction Company Limited. Now this is, guys, nothing but the famous bad bank that was in the news for quite some time. Now if you are a regular follower of the Union Budget or the current affairs in general, then you would know that this bad bank was announced by the finance minister in the Union Budget of 2021, and there she announced that this bank is going to become operational by the month of June 2021. And in order to make this organization operational, the first CEO of this organization has also been appointed, and it is the Padma Kumar M. Nair who has become the first CEO of this organization. Now, in very briefly, let me tell you that this bad bank is going to take over the bad assets or the non-performing assets of the lenders of the banks in India. And precisely, this is the function of this National Asset Reconstruction Company Limited. This has been created to clear off the bank books, clear off the books of the banks. Now, this company will take over the NPAs of the banks and will resolute the assets, the NPAs of these banks. Just remember that as per the recent guidelines of RBI, the frauds, the loans which have been termed as fraud cannot be transferred to this bad bank. Only the loans or the assets which have been termed as NPAs can be transferred to National Asset Reconstruction Company. So that was all about this question. Now we are moving on to the next question. Who has become the first woman of Asian descent to win the 2021 World Food Prize? So it is option C, Shakuntala Harasinghe Thistani. She is basically a native of Trinidad and Tobago. So it is a Caribbean island, and at present she is a citizen of Denmark. So remember her nationality as well as her place. Now she has won this 2021 World Food Prize. Just remember that she is of Indian origin. That's why it becomes very important for us to remember. And she is the first woman of Asian descent to win this World Food Prize. So that was all about this question and this video. Thank you so much for watching the video. I hope that you have enjoyed the video. And if you have, then do not forget to like this video and share it among your friends. Thank you so much for watching the video.